For this list, we'll be looking at the most prominent female artists that died young, tragically, and or unexpectedly. Regardless of the circumstances, these women were taken away in their prime. Did we forget one of your favorite artists? Let us know in the comments. Sophie. The Scottish musician Sophie Zeon released a unique kind of dance and electronic pop. In 2018, Sophie's debut album, Oil of Every Pearl's Uninsides, was released to critical acclaim and a Grammy nomination. Coming out as a trans woman, the trailblazing performer led the world as an important figure in music. While not achieving the status of major pop stars, the producer worked with more successful singers like Madonna and Charlie XCX. In 2021, at just 34, Sophie died after falling from a balcony in what was determined to be an accident. In the end, Sophie's bravery in embracing a true identity made for an incredibly influential legacy. Florence Ballard. As one of the original members of the Supremes, singer Florence Ballard achieved massive success in one of Motown's biggest acts. During the band's most productive years, the vocalist recorded some of their greatest hits. Due to her struggles with alcohol, the artist was fired from the Supremes in 1967. While she attempted to start a solo career, she was unable to match the accomplishments of her former group. During the 1970s, the performer fell on hard times and stopped singing for a short time. At the young age of 32, her life was cut short when she died of a sudden heart attack. Living on through her contributions to Motown, Ballard also served as the basis for the character Effie White in Dreamgirls. Dorothy Dandridge. Born in Cleveland, Dorothy Dandridge was destined for greatness from a young age. As a singer, she first made a name for herself in groups such as the Dandridge Sisters. Performing around the country, the artist honed her craft at iconic places like the Cotton Club. As an actor, she appeared in Porgy and Bess and received an Oscar nomination for her role in Carmen Jones.
And he don't do what you want him to, loving nobody's angel child.
Despite this success, she dealt with financial issues and dwindling film opportunities. Dandridge returned to her roots on the stage, singing as she juggled personal and monetary setbacks.
I can only give you country walks in springtime.
At the age of 42, she died from an overdose. Through Halle Berry's portrayal of her in introducing Dorothy Dandridge, people were reintroduced to the artist's one-of-a-kind talents.
I've got rhythm, I've got music, I got my man who could ask for anything more.
Dinah Washington. Known as the Queen of the Blues, Dinah Washington was one of the premier singers of the 1950s. From her start as a teenager, the performer built up her singing ability as a club act in the 1940s. In 1959, she won a Grammy for one of her most unforgettable recordings, What a Difference a Day Makes.
Lord, what a difference a day makes.
At the age of 39, Washington died of a barbiturate overdose. Her many indelible performances created a legend around her name.
I need to make it.
The classy delivery that set her apart.
I need to make it.
Her mastery of jazz, blues, and R&B, the vocalist became a 1993 inductee into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Meeting you was a happy accident.
Simone Battle. While Simone Battle tried her hand at show business before X Factor, it was the singing competition that made her a star. Her 2011 audition on the program brought her to a much larger stage, landing her a spot in the girl group GRL.
Maybe I'm just crazy. Maybe I'm a fool.
I survived.
Maybe I don't know how to love, but maybe I do.
All of her early acting gigs and music video work prepared her for the big time, including a successful collaboration with Pitbull. With 2 years in the group, the performer was well on her way to even larger musical achievements. Shocking the world, the 25-year-old singer took her own life in 2014. Through heartfelt tributes, her bandmates and admirers carried on her legacy and showed that she would never be forgotten. Mary Wells. Known for her association with early Motown, Mary Wells was another important piece of the record company's unprecedented success. As a teenager, Wells was one of the first female artists to have a successful single with the Detroit label. Releasing classics like My Guy, her abilities provided a strong foundation for the pop and R&B landscape.
Nothing you can do but make me dance with My Guy.
No, 4-6.
Singing various songs written by Smokey Robinson, the performer became one of the great solo stars of the early 1960s. After disagreements with Motown, Wells left to pursue work with different labels for the next two decades. In 1990, she received a cancer diagnosis that led to her death 2 years later. Ahead of her time, the vocalist's impeccable work made her the original, the Queen of Motown.
You beat me to the punch. You beat me to the punch.
Tammy Terrell. One of the shining lights of early Motown, Tammy Terrell achieved an incredible amount in her 24 years. Starting in her teens, the performer worked and recorded with James Brown. Showing tremendous promise, the singer formed a classic partnership with Marvin Gaye. The friends recorded Ain't No Mountain High Enough and You're All I Need to Get By, which became two all-time classics. After fainting in 1967, the artist found out she had a malignant brain tumor. Less than 3 years later, Terrell succumbed to her illness. In her brief career, she managed to put an indelible mark on popular music. Minnie Riperton. Known for one of the most dynamic vocal ranges in popular music, Minnie Riperton was nothing short of a singing powerhouse. Beginning her career as a backup singer, the performer garnered attention delivering backing vocals for the many artists at Chess Records. Captured in songs such as her magnum opus Lovin' You, her enviable register was unmatched during her initial reign.
Lovin' you is easy cause you're beautiful.
Receiving a breast cancer diagnosis in 1976, Riperton refused to let the illness stall her output. Continuing to record up until her death at 31, the vocalist also became an advocate for the American Cancer Society. Leaving behind a host of admirable work in and out of the industry, she was a true role model for future entertainers. Christina Grimmie. Before making a splash on season 6 of The Voice, singer Christina Grimmie released her own covers on YouTube.
Blow a kiss, vodka, no need someone to lean on.
Releasing an EP and an album, the performer already developed her sound prior to landing an audition on the NBC show. Once she made it to the show, she was mentored by Adam Levine and mastered her pop skills on stage.
I think that this song is an artistic choice to kind of stamp who you are beyond the competition.
Yep. Finishing in third place, she left the program with opportunities to join a major label and tour. After one of her live shows, Grimmie was shot and killed during an autograph signing with fans. Her shocking murder brought further attention to the issue of gun violence in America.
The suspect in this case is not from Orlando. The suspect traveled to Orlando, apparently to commit this crime, and then had plans to travel back to where he came from.
With another EP and album released after her death, Grimmie's promising career had only just begun. Eva Cassidy. During her life, singer and guitarist Eva Cassidy was more of a cult figure with a small following. She only had two official releases during her lifetime. Her haunting and emotional voice glided over a variety of covers, notably Sting's Fields of Gold.
I swear in the days still left, we'll walk in fields of gold.
mixing folk and jazz influences, her memorable performance style made her a notable DC performer. Dying from melanoma in 1996, her legend only grew as people rediscovered her albums. Years later, her recordings became popular in the UK, where her posthumous releases and compilations sold particularly well.
Someday, I wish upon a star.
Like many of the great artists in history, Cassidy finally received her due after her death. Cass Elliot. Cass Elliot, also known as Mama Cass, was a major musical presence in the late 1960s and early 1970s. One of the members of the Mamas and the Papas, the singer had the most commanding vocals in the entire group. Her rendition of Dream a Little Dream with Me off of their fourth album signaled her promise as a solo artist.
But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
With her variety specials and other media appearances, the vocalist became a well-known persona beyond just her initial song work. While she was maintaining a modest level of success, it all ended when Elliot died from heart failure in 1974. From her days as a counterculture icon to her tremendous voice, the performer made an immeasurable impact on the industry. Billie Holiday. If you have a favorite female vocalist, there's a chance she was influenced in part by Billie Holiday.
Nothing but the blues are brewing. The blues are brewing.
Among the most storied and well-regarded performers of any era, she performed standards of the 1940s and 1950s better than almost anyone. Her career as a jazz singer was punctuated by historic and culturally important recordings, one of which was her version of Strange Fruit.
Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees.
All the while, she dealt with the changing times and a cluster of legal problems. In 1959, Holiday died of cirrhosis after a long battle with addiction. While her story was tragic, many books and films ensured that her inspiring life and musical expertise would never be forgotten. Patsy Cline. Among the first female artists to serve up country music to pop listeners, Patsy Cline was nothing short of groundbreaking. With a fantastic vocal ability and rich tone, the singer managed to carve out her own piece of recording history. Her interpretation of the song Crazy, penned by Willie Nelson, produced a profound and earth-shattering effect on popular music.
I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
By the age of 30, she had conquered the charts and paved the way for women in her respective genre. In 1963, the performer tragically died in an airplane crash. Wise and talented beyond her years, Cline gave America their first female country superstar.
I go out walking after midnight, out in the moonlight, just like
Shopping.
Janis Joplin. There were few performers who had the power of Janis Joplin's voice.
I want to love you, love you.
From her time with Big Brother and The Holding Company to her solo career, this singer was a guiding light for 60s counterculture. Fashionable and down-to-earth, Joplin was known for her legendary renditions of songs like Piece of My Heart and Me and Bobby McGee. Unfortunately, her life ended at the young age of 27 after an accidental overdose. Even in her short life, the artist achieved a mythical status as one of the greatest rock vocalists of the Woodstock generation. Karen Carpenter. The brother and sister duo The Carpenters became soft rock staples in the 1970s. As their lead vocalist, Karen Carpenter's angelic voice bolstered several huge records. Songs such as Rainy Days and Mondays and Superstar were big songs with pop listeners.
Don't you remember you told me you love me, baby?
With multiple Grammys and hit singles to their name, the group seemingly had it all despite their own personal struggles. Suffering from body image issues, Carpenter dealt with eating disorders during the height of the band's success. These contributed to the singer's death in 1983, after her lengthy battle with anorexia. At just 32, the artist died much too young, and with many wonderful songs left to sing. Amy Winehouse. Appointed as the next great British pop singer, Amy Winehouse soared to fame with an enviable vocal talent. In just two solo albums, the performer garnered commercial and critical acclaim with hits like Valerie and Rehab. Her record, Back to Black, brought her international fame and Grammy Awards. With even greater success on the horizon, Winehouse accumulated several promising projects and offers in the early 2010s. Battling addictions and personal demons, the vocalist struggled at the peak of her fame. My heart's on a stand, I go back to black. Dying from alcohol poisoning in 2011, the artist's life was cut short under unfortunate circumstances. Although her life ended in tragedy, her star shined brighter than anyone could have imagined. Lisa Left Eye Lopez. Providing a fun and vibrant energy to TLC, Lisa Left Eye Lopez rounded out the R&B trio. Go, go, chasing waterfalls. Contributing to one of the best-selling female groups of all time, the singer and rapper made her mark on a number of massive songs. Adding her charm to the videos for No Scrubs and Creep, Lopez was the group's secret ingredient. During a charity trip in Honduras, the artist was killed in a car crash. With the promise of her solo career and producer credits, the performer was on the cusp of several prosperous ventures. Leaving us too soon, Left Eye's lasting impression on pop and R&B lived on through TLC's timeless discography. Whitney Houston. In 1985, Whitney Houston charted a course that would alter the landscape for female vocalists. By her mid-20s, the artist had already delivered massive records that showcased her impeccable singing talents. Releasing a cover of I Will Always Love You, she reached stratospheric heights as an unrivaled singer. Through her illustrious and award-winning career, Houston's unprecedented talents extended well beyond the music industry. Later in life, her controversial marriage to Bobby Brown and drug use led to her decline. The latter contributed to her tragic death from an accidental drowning, along with a heart condition. Nevertheless, the legend's output left an overwhelmingly positive effect on popular culture. Aaliyah. Signed at the age of 12, Aaliyah was well on her way to stardom before most people finished junior high. 3 years later, her debut album signaled the rise of another great artist. In 2001, the singer boarded a plane in the Bahamas that crashed not long after takeoff. Given all of Aaliyah's achievements before her death, it's clear that she left us long before she reached her full potential.
Come on, I wanted those tacos and baggies.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
Fair.
You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. After starting with the band Los Dinos, she continued as a solo artist with 5 studio albums. Her star shined brightly as she achieved so much in her 23 years. In a shock to the world, the artist was shot and killed by her former fan club president. Following the senseless tragedy, the multi-platinum Dreaming of You became a record-breaking album for Latin music. 'Cause I'm dreaming. Immediately following her death, her many fans made it clear that they would never